And welcome back, folks. Welcome back to Let's Play Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde, level 3. So last time, I had to completely restart the game. Because as we learned, this game remembers your progress. Basically, that you make is Hyde. And if you get too far as Hyde, that is, you die too often and you spend too much time being Hyde, the game simply will become basically unwinnable. I mean, almost unwinnable. You can still, if you can completely avoid going into the Hyde form at this point, you can still win the game, but if you go to the Hyde form, you will get basically pretty much immediately get hit by lightning and you will die. So it's still possible to play the game, but you basically have lost your ability to recuperate your life by going to Hyde. And the enemy shot 4 projectiles there, which was unexpected, and I think if I'm not careful, I'm going to die here. I'm very close to death. But I made it. This was very close. If you just... if you're unlucky or... you're just bad at dodging these projectiles, your health can gets whittled down very fast, and so if I start the Hyde stage with full health, I'm almost more scared than if I started with low health, because I just know that I'm going to lose all of this health due to my own stupidity like this. And I'm dead, and we are going to lose all of the progress that we have made so far in the third level. I think it must be an hour at least that I'm trying to beat level 3. Or probably more than an hour. I have definitely beaten level 3 yesterday. I did a little bit of practicing. And I got to the barrel stage. Which is pretty much the last stage of the game. Which is also by far the hardest stage. At least that's what I thought yesterday. Yeah, and I'm dead again, and shit. Okay. It's almost impossible to dodge these townspeople. And on top of that, you still have to dodge, well, Billy Pawns. You have to dodge this purple guy. And even when you're dodging, you have to still be aware of new enemies that spawn from the left and the right. So yeah, you just, well, actually, okay, I think I will try an experiment. So, apparently in the barrel stage, it is possible, basically to just outweigh the AI. So after some time, there won't be any more barrels. So it will only spawn finitely many barrels, and if this is true for enemies as well, I might simply outweigh these townspeople and... Yeah! Okay, so I will try that. I will just, but then again, it's easier said than done, dodging these townspeople, because, look at this. So. By the way, this game has zero to do with the book. Because this, I know this because I read the book. It was actually pretty good. It was a very, yeah. Sort of old-fashioned, this old-fashioned horror that is more creepy than really disgusting. Okay, we are still alive somewhat. And see there, when even the tiniest enemies... So the problem with this game is not that each enemy individually is hard, but all of that all of them at the same time just breaks your neck. I mean, especially because you will get knocked back towards other enemies. So... In other words, one could say that the difficulty of Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde, scheiße, this difficulty is, scheiße. Well, that this difficulty has an emergent quality. So this is another reason why I think that this game is well designed. That this was designed by someone who really knew what he was doing. Even if this thing that he wanted to achieve was to create a game that is just... It is borderline unplayable. It is almost as frustrating that it's unplayable. But only almost. I mean, I'm still playing this, and despite all my rage, strangely enough, it's still somewhat enjoyable. Despite the frustration, I still enjoy the basic gameplay. So, Yeah. It may not be the best game ever made, but I think it's a good game. I really do think this game is good. And I'm certainly not saying this just in a desperate attempt to persuade the game to let me finish level 3. No, I would never do that. I would never do that at all. Totally being honest here. Totally my own opinion. So I need to learn not to jump over Billy Pawns. Because this is one unnecessary jump that will leave me exposed. So I did it again. It just leaves me exposed to the other enemies. Also, as we have learned, Billy Pawns is our friend, in fact. As are the spiders. The spiders will take away only your jackal meter. Whereas the townspeople, they will take away your life meter. So, spiders and Billy Pawns, they are in fact your friend. What is not your friend are these red orbs. They are not your friend. If you can kill them, which is difficult but possible, should definitely do. And sometimes when those brains jump high, it's difficult to get the timing right. Okay. Okay. We've made this. I mean, we're still not very far into the third level, but maybe using Billy Pawns purposefully for our own advantage might actually be the strategy. Should have get hit by this. Maybe this is actually the strategy to win this game. I mean, to get at least past the third level. So, wanna avoid you. Wanna avoid you. And I'm very much screwed because, I'm almost dead. And what will happen now, I will get hit by an orb immediately. I will get hit by an orb immediately and then I will die. This is what's going to happen. Shit. Scheiße, okay. I should have tried to hit this green guy. Yeah, I was trying to jump there, but the timing just wasn't. This wasn't right, okay. Okay, we are still playing. Okay. Still playing on level 3, but now at least we have a new strategy, and that strategy is basically to abuse spiders and Billy Pawns. In order to, so this was good, even though I think we lost a little bit of health there. My timer tells me to stop playing this game, which I will in fact do now, because, well, we're dead anyway, and then, yeah. So this is a good point to stop the game. I'm not sure that I will, well, maybe we will continue, I'm not sure. Because basically I'm, yeah, I run out of time, but yeah, if this doesn't continue, then I hope this provided you with some entertainment for the coming Halloween days. Yeah, so until next time, until then.